pardon our transgressions. O Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to ages of ages.
Amen. Holy and divine, instrument of wisdom, joyful trumpet of theology, together we sing thy praises, O God-inspired Gregory. Sit thou now stand as before the original mind, guide our minds to him, O Father, so that we may sing to thee, rejoice, O creature of grace. Now is the time for action, judgment is at the doors, so let us rise and fast, offering alms with tears of compunction and crying. Our sins are more in number than the sands of the sea, but forgive us, O Master of all, so that we may receive the incorruptible crowns. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Thou, at every season, every hour, in heaven and on earth, art worshipped and glorified, O Christ our God. Long-suffering, merciful, and compassionate, who dost love the just, and show mercy upon the sinner, who dost call all men to salvation through the promise of blessings to come. O Lord, in this hour, receive our supplications and direct our lives according to thy commandments. Sanctify our souls, hallow our bodies, correct our thoughts, cleanse our minds. Deliver us from all tribulations, evil, and distress. Surround us with thy holy angels, and guide and guarded by their host. We may attain to the unity of this faith and to the knowledge of thine unapproachable glory, for thou art blessed unto ages of ages. Amen. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to ages of ages. Amen. More honorable than the cherubim, and more glorious beyond compare than the seraphim. Without the defilement you gave birth to God, the Word, true, Theotokos, we magnify thee. In the name of the Lord, Father, bless.
Prayers of our holy fathers, O Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Amen. O God, the Lord of hosts and Father of all creation, who in thy boundless tender mercy has sent down thine only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, for the salvation of the human race, and through his holy cross has torn up the handwriting of our sins and thereby triumphed over the princes and dominions of darkness. Do thou, O Master, who lovest mankind, accept these prayers of thanksgiving and supplication even from us sinners, and deliver us from every deadly and dark transgression and from all the visible and invisible enemies that seek to do us harm. Nail our flesh with the fear of thee, and let not our hearts incline to evil words or thoughts, but wound our souls with thy love, that ever gazing upon thee, guided by thy light and beholding thee, the eternal light that no man can approach, we may send up unceasing praises and thanks unto thee, the Father without beginning, together with thine only begotten Son, and thy most holy, good and life-giving Spirit, now and ever, and to ages of ages. Amen.
Glory be to Jesus Christ.
Glory forever.
Although the S-U-N is being blocked over for today, the S-O-N, sun, is shining brightly on this church today, because we are welcoming two new warriors for Christ in the soon-to-be-named Photini and Marina. So we'll begin the Divine Liturgy with the affirmations of faith, and as they had their life confessions yesterday afternoon, they'll receive the remission of sins and the prayer of the absolution in the center of the church, and then we'll begin Divine Liturgy as normal, and then right in the middle, right before the Holy God, they'll be chrismated, and I'll stop and explain a little bit more about what's happening with that. But first, the affirmations of faith. We'll all say the creed together here in a few minutes, and we will keep in the process of welcoming these two lovely ladies into the Holy Orthodox faith. Trinity of the Virgin Mary be a local, reign with Christ in heaven. And that according to the understanding of the Holy Word about church, it is proper to honor and invoke them, and that the prayers and intercessions avail with the kind-hearted God for the salvation, for our salvation. And it is also pleasing to God to venerate the grace for our brothers. We recognize that it is proper to keep and to honor icons of Christ the Savior, the ever-Virgin Mary, the Holy Father of God, and other saints, not as idolaters, but that by looking on them we might be inspired to piety and to imitate the deeds of the righteous person representing the holy icon. You confess that the prayers of the faithful offered up to God for the salvation of those departed as they are acceptable through the mercy of God. You believe and confess that the founder, head, great high priest, and archpastor of the Holy Orthodox Church is our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, and that by the bishops, pastors, and teachers are appointed to the church, and that the guide and guidance of the church is the Holy Spirit. You confess that this same church is the bride of Christ, and that in her is true salvation. You promise true obedience to the bishops of the Orthodox Church and to the priests appointed by them unto the end of your life. And finally, you believe in one God, who
shine in their hearts, O Master, the perfect light of the grace of thy Holy Spirit, for the enlightening knowledge of the truth of thy holy gospel. Grant them unfadingly, irrevocably, without hypocrisy, to unite themselves to thy holy church, truly accepting and confessing the orthodox faith. Number them in thy chosen flock, unite them to the body of thy holy church. Make them be vessels of honor and dwelling place of thy Holy Spirit, that ever nourished and guided by thy Holy Spirit, they may observe thy commandments, and that by doing thy good and perfect will, they may be counted worthy to receive thy heavenly good things together with those who have been well pleasing unto thee. For thou art the God of mercies and compassions and love for men, and thou didst desire that all should be saved and come to thee. To thee, and to thee, to ascribe glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. May God imparted David to make him a prophet. Peter, who went bitterly for his denial, the harlot weeping in his feet, the publican and prophet. May the same God forgive you his servant of the need. All these things to be a sinner, both in this world and the world to come, and send you uncondemned before his loss and judgment seat. Now, having known for the care of the sins that you have confessed, depart in peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Rise, sisters, stand up and stand in fear as a faithful servant of Jesus Christ, together with
Lord's vessel of darkness, let us pray us to be your master, and impart the riches of thy mercy and thy compassion to us and to those who pray with us.
Thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Mankind, and unto thee do we send up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. send up glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever.
Water that, of which we were not first from. So again, we'll now just make that, we'll say a prayer, and we'll just make that.
this attend.
Peace be unto all.
And to your spirit.
Wisdom. Attend.
You, O Lord, at the beginning laid the foundation of the earth, and the heavens are the work of your hands. They will perish, but you remain. They will all grow old like a garment, like a cloak. You will fold them up, and they will be changed. But you are the same, and your years will not fail. But which of the angels has he ever said, "Sit at my right hand till I make your enemies your footstool"? Are they not all ministering spirits sent forth to minister for those who will inherit salvation? Therefore, we must give the most earnest heed to the prudency of her, lest we drift away. For if the word spoken through angels proved steadfast, and every transgression and disobedience received a just reward, how shall we escape if we neglect so great a salvation, which at the first began to be spoken by the Lord, and was confirmed to us by those who heard him? Brethren, it was fitting that we should have such a high priest, who is holy, harmless, undefiled, separate from sinners, and has become higher than the heavens, who does not need daily as those high priests to offer up sacrifices first for his own sins and then for the people. For this he did once and for all, when he offered up himself. For the law appoints as high priests men who have weakness, but the word of the oath which came after the law appoints the Son, who has been perfected forever. Now this is the main point of the things we are saying. We have such a high priest who is seated at the right hand of the throne of the majesty in the heavens, the minister of the sanctuary, and of the true tabernacle, which the Lord erected and not man.
Peace be unto thee who reads.
And to your spirit, alleluia.
Gospel teachings, implant also in us the fear of thy blessed commandments, and trampling down all carnal desires, we may enter upon a spiritual manner of living, both thinking and doing such things as are well pleasing unto thee. For thou art the illumination of our souls and bodies, O Christ our God, and unto thee do we send up glory, together with thy Father, who is from everlasting, and then all holy, good, and life creating Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen.
Blessed Master, who proclaims the glad tidings of the holy apostle and evangelist of all.
May God, through the prayers of the holy, glorious, and laudable apostle and evangelist Mark, enable to proclaim the glad tidings with great power to the fulfillment of the gospel of his beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Peace be unto all. I wanted to offer some encouragement to our newly illumined warrior sisters of Christ, Photini and Marina, and to the Holy Church here today, because, you know, the church offered me a lot of things of which to preach about today. We heard from the example of the paralytic. I could have offered some word about needing to, we remember how in the paralytic, the story of the gospel just read about fighting through the crowds. They had to fight through the crowds in order to bring their friend to Christ. We could have talked about fighting through the craziness of the world in order to come to Christ, or we could have spoken about the value of friendship and all of these new brothers and sisters that you have here, that the paralytic was saved because of the faith of his friends who brought him to Christ, who put their interests above their own. I could have talked about St. Gregory of Palamas, and I still might. But I think, what better example to offer you today than that of our mother, the Panagia, the Theotokos? This past Monday, we celebrated, only 9 months till Christmas, we celebrated the feast of the Annunciation of our Lord to the Annunciation to the Theotokos Mary, that our Lord was going to be born her. And we remember how on this 9 months before Christmas, Mary was told for the first time that she was about to become the chosen vessel of God himself to come into the world. Now, if you think about that, this scene had to be absolutely mind-blowing. I think sometimes we read in the gospel and we're like, oh, that's nice, Mary said yes. You know, what a great, you know, we clap our hands, you know. But
think about the weight of what happened in that moment. I think where we get some clarity, and one of the things that I love about the Orthodox Church, which you have entered into, is that Holy Scripture for us is almost like, the life of our Lord is almost like a big coloring book. And Holy Scripture provides the lines of the coloring book. It shows us a very beautiful picture. But it's the worship services, it's the writings of the fathers, it's the things like the Matin service for Annunciation that give color. Color to this picture completes the picture for us. And the Matins, the canon service for Annunciation, is no different. We get all of the outline from Holy Scripture itself. We know the scene. This young but very faithful girl was sitting and sewing a curtain for the temple, which is, by the way, depicted in the icon of the Annunciation. You see it on the royal doors. Mary, sitting there, sewing the curtain for the temple. And all of a sudden, she's interrupted. And the angel of the Lord comes upon her, and we read in Scripture how he says, "Rejoice, highly favored one, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women. Don't be afraid, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bring forth a son. You shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever and ever, and his kingdom will have no end." Now, if we were to listen to the worship services, that's the outline. Now we add the color. And the canon is a very interesting canon because most of the verses of the canon serve as a dialogue, a kind of inner working of what must have been going through the mind of the Theotokos and of the angel Gabriel as they were having this conversation. So the canon is written as this conversation piece, back and forth, back and forth. And it starts with the Theotokos. And she thinks and she says to the archangel Gabriel, she says, "There is no more a prince in Judah's line, but the time is at hand in which Christ, the hope of the Gentiles, should appear." But she says, "But can you clarify this for me?" I'm paraphrasing. This is not what the canon, it doesn't say, "Can you clarify this for me?" She says, the canon says, "But can you make plain to me how I, a virgin, shall bear this Son of God? Can you just humor me and tell me how I'm just this simple little virgin girl, 12, 13 years old, how is it that God, that, is coming down into me?" And the archangel Gabriel says, "O virgin, you seek to know from me the manner of your conceiving? This is beyond all interpretation. The Holy Spirit shall overshadow you, and in his creative power shall make all of this come to pass." So he says, "You're asking me how all this is supposed to come to be?" He says, "The Holy Spirit will make this work." And the Theotokos then shows a little bit of caution. She says, "You know, my mother Eve, accepting the suggestion of a serpent, was banished from divine delight. And therefore, I fear your strange salutation, and I take heed lest I slip." She's like, "You know, I've heard something like this before somewhere." And the angel says, he says, "I am sent as the envoy of God to disclose to you the divine will. Why are you, O undefiled one, how could you be afraid of me? Rather, it is I that fear you. Why, O lady, do you stand in awe of me, who stand in reverent awe of you?" So the church is adding to this incredibly beautiful scene, showing that even the angel Gabriel, who was announcing this miracle to her, was just so overwhelmed with the miracle that was happening. God coming down, taking his abode in the womb of this simple teenager. And now lies the encouragement that I offer both of you and everyone here today who are walking this narrow path of salvation. Despite all of those prevailing thoughts, all of those things that defy logic, what was the response of Mary in Holy Scripture? She says, "Behold the maidservant of the Lord, let it be according to your word." She says, yes. Simple and absolute perfect faith. Because I so often wonder that if I was a 12 or 13 year old teenage girl living in today, what would I be responding to that very thing in my own life? This angel appears to us and says, you know, you're going to be the vessel in which God enters the world. And our response is, no, I'm not really sure that you're an angel. Or, you know, I'm a virgin. How am I supposed to stop the ridicule and the judgment that my family might pass on me, who will no doubt probably stone me for this? Or maybe my own head, being a former financial advisor, is he going to be born before January 1st because there's a child tax credit that I want to take part in? All of these logical, stupid responses, that last one especially, all of these logical responses tied up in trying to wrap our little brains around this miracle, trying to use logic to dictate our response to God. Yet our Lord in the Beatitudes never said, blessed are the smart, blessed are the logical. He said, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. And so Photini, Marina, when you first came to this church, both of you did so in a very small way with your mind. You made a decision to visit. You made a decision to learn about the faith, to embrace something that was a little bit different, but greater than yourself. And now that your journey begins today, while the mind will no doubt still play a very small role, now your attention should fall to the transformation of your heart. And it's the transformation of your heart that goes beyond human logic. And what better example than following the perfect Christian, Theotokos, to emulate in your life? She lived in the same type of doubting world that all of us are a part of today, yet she was able to counter the poking and the prodding of the devil who tempts us each and every day to give up on the gift that you have received today, to take it for granted what you are about to receive today. And my advice to you, dear sisters in Christ, is to live every day of your life by escaping your head and learning to live in your heart. This is where God dwells, not here, in here. That was the message of St. Gregory Palamas. Most of his writings, his famous writings and his homilies, were centered around the experience of God through the church, through the Holy Mysteries, through Holy Chrismation, through the Holy Eucharist that you will participate here in shortly, and through constant prayer of the heart. This is what the Mother of God did throughout her entire life. She learned how to defy logic and live in her heart, and that's why we look upon her not just as an example. This is the example of how to approach God in your new life. It's through the Blessed Mother. And so may our Lord give you and each and every one of us all of the strength to once again not live in the fallen world and in the logic of our human mind, which is so limited, but to live deep down in the deepest crevices of the heart, because that's where God dwells. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Glory be to Jesus Christ.
Glory to God. Especially Michael, Stephanie, Jason, David, Chad, John, Alex, Sarah, and Mark. Again, we pray for the blessed and ever-memorable Holy Orthodox Patriarchs, and for the blessed and ever-memorable founders of this holy house, and for all our fathers and brethren who have actually departed this life before us, especially the recently departed servants of God, Suzanne, David, Barbara, Richard, and Demetrios, who here in all the world lie asleep in the Lord. Again, we pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, and visitation for the servants of God, Archbishop Alexander, Archbishop Nathaniel, Subdeacon Paul, Vinnie, Elaine, David, Pat, Michael, Lauren, Mason, Teresa, Robert, Arminda, Richard, Kayla, Stephanie, Martin, Shirley, Nadia, Hudson, Jeanette, Richard, Paul, Mike, John, Harry, Patricia, Dottie, Gary, Hannah, and Shawnee, for mothers with child, Catherine, Chloe, Allison, Lauren, Natanya, Renee, Emily, Natushka, Danielle, Jacqueline, and Lauren, and for our catechumens, Landon, Ethan, Allison, Stella, Vera, Kane, Stephanie, Derek, Alexis, Maverick, Camden, Ryan, Morgan, Milo, Gavin, Nathan, Catherine, Thomas, Aaron, Skyler, Theodore, and Scott, and for the newly illumined handmaidens of God, Photini and Marina, and for the pardon and remission of their sins.
Pray that the Lord our God will bless the good intentions and works of we his children, the faithful of St. Mary Magdalene Parish, by the grace, guidance, and indwelling of the most holy, good, and life, creating spirit, may strive to build up this holy community to his glory. We pray thee, O Lord, hear us and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
And we ask great mercy upon our brothers and sisters who are presently involved in the conflicts, Ukraine, Russia, Israel, and Palestine. Remove from their midst all hostility, confusion, and hatred. Lead everyone along the path of reconciliation and peace. We pray, O Lord, hear us and have mercy.
Again, we pray for those who bring offerings and do good works in this holy and venerable house, for those who labor and those who sing, and for all the people here present, who await thy great and rich mercy.
God, a merciful God, and love us mankind, and unto thee do we send up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen.
Pray to the Lord, the catechumens. Let us the faithful pray for the catechumens that the Lord may have mercy on them. He may teach them the word of truth. He may reveal to them the gospel of righteousness. He may unite them with his holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. Help them, save them, have mercy on them. Keep them, O God, by thy grace. Bow your heads unto the Lord, ye catechumens.
Name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and in the ages of ages.
All catechumens depart, depart catechumens, all other catechumens depart. Let no catechumen remain. Let us, the faithful, again and again in peace, pray unto the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Wisdom.
For unto thee are due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and in the age of
again, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom.
That guarded always by thy might, we may send up glory unto thee, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Thank you.
us into this life, who has shown us the ways of salvation bestowed upon us.
Let us put up prayers to the Lord.
Thou art the one who has appointed us to the service by the power of the Holy Spirit. Son, with whom thou art blessed, together with an all holy, good, and life, creating spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Thank you.
Christ, the love of God, the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit, be with all of you. Magnificence of thy holiness, to praise thee, to sing to thee, to bless thee, to worship thee, to give thanks to thee, to glorify thee, the only truly existing God, and to offer to thee this our reasonable worship with a contrite heart and a spirit of humility. For thou hast granted us the knowledge of thy truth. Who can utter thy mighty acts or make all thy praises known or tell of all thy miracles at all times? O Master of all, Lord of heaven and earth and of all creation, both visible and invisible, who sittest upon the throne of glory and beholdest the depths without beginning, invisible, incomprehensible, indescribable, changeless, O Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the great God and Savior, our hope, who is the image of thy goodness, the seal of thy very likeness, showing forth in himself thee, O Father, the living word, the true God, the eternal wisdom, the life, the sanctification, the power, the true light, to whom the Holy Spirit was revealed, the Spirit of truth, gift, the Spirit of truth, the gift of sonship, the pledge of future inheritance, the first fruits of eternal blessings, the life-creating power, the fountain of sanctification, to whom every creature of reason and understanding worships thee and always sings to thee a hymn of glory, for all things are thy servants. Thou art praised by angels, archangels, thrones, dominions, principalities, authorities, and powers. The many-eyed cherubim round about thee stand the seraphim, one with six wings, the other with six wings. With two they cover their faces, with two they cover their feet, with two they fly, crying to one another with unceasing voices and ever-resounding praises, singing the triumphant hymn, shouting, proclaiming, and saying,
Holy, 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 Holy,
mankind, we sinners also cry out and say, Holy art thou, truly most holy, and there are no bounds to the magnificence of thy holiness. Thou art gracious in all thy deeds, for with righteousness and true judgment thou hast ordered all things for us. When thou didst create man by taking dust from the earth and dishonor him with thine own image, O God, thou didst set him in a paradise of delight, promising him eternal life and the enjoyment of everlasting blessings in the observance of thy commandments. But when man disobeyed thee, the true God who had created them, and was deceived by the guile of the serpent, becoming subject to death through his own transgressions, thou, O God, in thy righteous judgment, didst send him forth from paradise into this world, returning him from the earth from which he was taken, yet providing for him the salvation of regeneration in thy Christ himself. For thou dost not turn thyself away forever from thy creature whom thou hast made, O good one, nor dost thou forget the work of thy hands. Through the tender compassion of thy mercy, thou dost visit him in various ways. Thou dost send prophets, thou dost perform mighty works by thy saints, who in every generation are well-pleasing to thee. Thou dost speak to us by the mouth of thy servants, the prophets, foretelling us the salvation which was to come. Thou dost give us the law as a help. Thou dost appoint angels as guardians, and when the fullness of time had come, thou dost speak to us through thy Son himself, by whom thou dost also make the ages, who being the radiance of thy glory and the image of thy person, upholding all things by the word of his power, thought it not robbery to be equal to thee, the God and Father. He was God before the ages, yet he appeared on earth and lived among men, becoming incarnate of a holy virgin. He emptied himself, taking the form of a servant, being likened to the body of our lowliness, that he might liken us to the image of his glory. For as by man sin entered into the world, and by sin death, so it pleased that only begotten Son, who was in the bosom of thee, the God and Father, who was born of a woman, the holy Theotokos, and of a virgin Mary, who was born under the law to condemn sin in his flesh, so that those who were dead in Adam might be made alive in thy Christ himself. He lived in this world and gave his commandments of salvation, releasing us from the delusions of idolatry. He brought us to knowledge of thee, the true God and Father. He obtained us for his own chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation. And having cleansed us in water and sanctified us with the Holy Spirit, he gave himself as a ransom to death, in which we were held captive, sold under sin. And ascending to the cross into hell, that he might fill all things with himself, he loosed the pangs of death. He rose on the third day, having made for all flesh a path to the resurrection from the dead, since it was not possible for the author of life to be a victim of corruption. And so he became the first fruits of those who had fallen asleep, the firstborn of the dead, that he might be himself truly the first in all things. Ascending into heaven, he sat down at the right hand of thy majesty on high. He will come to render to every man according to his works. And as memorials of his saving passion, he has left us these things which we have set forth according to his command. For when he was about to go forth to his voluntary and ever-memorable life, bearing death, in the night in which he gave himself up for the life of the world, he took bread into his holy, pure, and blameless hands. And having shown it to thee, the God and Father, having given thanks and blessed it and hallowed it and broken it, he gave it to his holy disciples and apostles, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body which is broken for you, for the remission of sins." He gave it to his holy disciples and apostles, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins." Do this in remembrance of me, for as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim my death, you confess my resurrection. Therefore, we also, Master, remembering his saving passion and life-creating cross, his three-day burial and resurrection from the dead, his ascension into heaven and sitting at the right hand of thee, the God and Father, and his glorious and awesome second coming, thine own of thy own, we offer unto thee on behalf of all and for all. Holy Master, we also, thy sinful and unworthy servants, whom thou hast permitted to serve at thy holy altar, not because of our unrighteousness, for we have done nothing good upon the earth, but because of thy mercy and compassions, which thou hast so richly poured out on us, we now dare to approach thy holy altar, and offering thee the antitypes of thy holy body and blood of thy Christ, we pray thee and call upon thee, O Holy of Holies, that by the favor of thy goodness, thy Holy Spirit may come upon us and upon these gifts now offered to bless, to hallow and to show this bread to be the precious body of our Lord and God and Savior Christ. Amen. That which is in this cup to be the precious blood of our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Shed for the life of the world. Amen. 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 And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. May the Lord God remember your prayer to be active in this kingdom, always, now, and ever. Unite all of us to one another, to become partakers of the one bread and cup in the communion of the Holy Spirit. Grant that none of us may partake of the holy body and blood of thy Christ for judgment or for condemnation. Instead, may we find mercy and grace with all the saints who through the ages have been well pleasing to thee, ancestors, fathers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, preachers, evangelists, martyrs, confessors, teachers, and every righteous spirit made perfect in faith. Especially for our most holy, most pure, most blessed and glorious Lady, the Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary. Thank you. we have not remembered through ignorance, forgetfulness, or multitude of names, since thou knowest the name and age of each, even from his mother's womb. For thou, Lord our God, art the helper of the helpless, the hope of the hopeless, the savior of the storm, the haven of the voyager, the physician of the sick. Be all things to all men, O thou who knowest each man in his request, his home and his need. Deliver this city, O Lord, and every city and country from famine, plague, earthquake, flood, fire, the sword, the invasion of enemies, and civil war. Among the first, remember, O Lord, his beheaded chair, Metropolitan Tifon, his eminence, Archbishop Alexander. Grant that the holy churches in peace, safety, honor, health, and length of days, right to divide the word of thy truth. Grant that with one mouth and one heart may praise thy honorable, majestic name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. May the mercies of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ be with all of you.
Having remembered all the saints again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For as the precious gifts offered and sanctified, let us pray to the Lord. Sweet spiritual fragrance will send down upon us in return his divine grace and gift of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Save
us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Having asked for the unity of the faith and the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
And without condemnation, we may dare to call upon thee, the heavenly God, as Father, and to say, Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be unto all.
Bind your hands unto the Lord.
Through the grace, compassion, and love to mankind of the only begotten Son, with whom thou art blessed, together with an all holy, good, and life creating Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Tell the Lord Jesus Christ, our God, out of thy holy dwelling place, from the glory of the glory of thy kingdom, and come to sanctify us. Allow us to sit on high with the Father, and our here and visibly present with us, and by thy mighty hand impart unto us thy most pure body and precious blood, and through us, through all the people, God, cleanse me the sinner, and have mercy on me. God, cleanse me the sinner, and have mercy on me. Oh God, cleanse me the sinner, and have mercy on me.
Let us attend.
The holy things are for the holy.
Amen. blood of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ.
Precious body of our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ, given unto the worthy protodeacon Michael for the remission of his sins, to life everlasting. Amen. Christ is an amen.
Peace and all shall be.
My brothers, forgive me all I have done in word and deed and thought and knowledge or in ignorance. Brothers and sisters in Christ, forgive me all I have done in word and deed and thought and knowledge or in ignorance. Lo, once again I draw near to my immortal King and God. Precious body of our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ is given unto me, the unworthy priest Gabriel, for the remission of my sins and unto life everlasting. Amen. I believe, O Lord, the Son of the living God,
who came to sinners, of whom I am first. I believe also that this is truly thy own most pure body, and that this is truly thy precious blood. Therefore I pray thee, mercy upon me, and forgive my transgressions, both voluntary and involuntary,
of word and of deed,
committed in knowledge or in ignorance, and make me worthy to partake without condemnation of thy most pure mysteries, for the remission of my sins, and unto life everlasting. Amen. Of thy mystical supper, O Son of God, accept me today as the beginning. For I will not speak of thy mysteries to thy enemies. Neither will I hear this, for I give thee a kiss. But I believe, for I confess thee. Remember me, O Lord, in thy kingdom. And may the commandment of thy holy mysteries be neither to my judgment, nor to my condemnation, O Lord, but to the healing of soul and body.
O God, cleanse me, the sinner, and have mercy on me, O Lord. I have sinned without number, O God, be good.
Thank you.
to the fasting of recent confession, or a blessing from their spiritual father will be led into you today by the newly illumined servants of God, Marina and Photini, reminding us of that first time that we all partake of the Holy Eucharist, and for the first time we come truly united to the body and blood of God himself. Oh, yes, after they receive, please have the children and the church school teachers go as they'll be dismissed for their classes after that.
Receive the Father of God, taste the fountain of grace.
is our God, always, now, and ever, in the two ages of ages. Send up glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Let us depart in peace.
Thank you.
have preserved them, O Lord, for many years.
God grant you many years. God grant you many years. God grant you many, many, many years.
This is your last congratulations to you both on this very beautiful day that you've been welcoming the fullness of the Holy Orthodox faith. It may be a wonderful and beautiful beginning of things to come for all of you. So again, congratulations. Thank you to the sponsors. Congratulations to the sponsors who have got two new daughters to add to the prayer list. And congratulations to indeed all of us who have become witnesses and partakers of this Chismation service and of this journey that these two have begun today. And I will keep you both for many blessed years.
We're going to take a memory eternal for the people that we remember departed the faith this week, which are the servants of God, Richard Phillips, Cyrus Lazar, Louis Gendrop, and Paul the Grandfather, Amanda Oxley. Will take a many years, or we'll take a memory eternal for them as we remember their calling this week. And rest eternal in blessed repose, O Lord. To the souls of thy departed servants, Richard, Cyrus, Louis, and Paul, who have fallen asleep, and make their memory to thee. Lesson while they're here.
her birthday yesterday, so we'll take many years for her birthday yesterday. But welcome. The working both for Lincoln Financial, right? Lincoln Investments down in Clarkston. So any investment needs, Eric is here with her. Raise your hand if Alex is an accountant, but she's probably not too often her services because she's a corporate accountant, not like a tax accountant, which all you need before you can compete. So again, don't ask her for that. The corporate accounting. Any businesses that need accounting, maybe? No?
No.
She's busy with Lincoln, so we'll leave her alone with that. But welcome to them as well. Celebrating their birthdays. Also, Basil Keegan and John White, celebrating their birthdays will take many years for them as well. We all have a very blessed and peaceful Sunday, especially our new women. We should congratulate our new sisters in Christ as we part of the church today. Grant the Lord a prosperous and peaceful life, rich with blessings, joy, health, and salvation. To thy servants, Alexandra, Basil, and John, celebrating their birthdays, and preserve them, O Lord, for many years.